With more now on the latest IRS controversy, I'm joined by roll call Shira Toplitz, Politico's James Holman. Good to see both of you.
Good to be with you, Craig.
Good to see you too.
James, let's start with the obvious. What the hell's happening at the IRS?
It's outrageous and it's out of control. It's endemic. I think this is no longer something that was isolated to the Cincinnati field office. This speaks to a broad, cultural, widespread, systemic issue that is across the bureaucracy. This is kind of a commonplace thing that was an agency out of control, partly because it was independent. It's not as sexy for Republicans. You know, it's great for people to watch because it doesn't go directly to the president. It doesn't tie to the White House, but it really is a problem, and I think most Americans are aghast as they watch some of these videos.
And also taken aback by the really bad dancing too that apparently
awful.
But that's for neither here nor there. Shira, how much of a black eye is this going to be for the White House, for the administration, or is this something that's now separate from the White House and the administration?
I think it's going to be very hard for the average voter to try and differentiate between this, even though the IRS is technically an independent agency, and the White House and President Obama's administration. And that's because the nature of the news that's come out about the IRS. It's really been a drip, drip, drip. James used the word systemic, and that's, I think, what a lot of people will view this as, just because there has been scandal after scandal, or let's say mini scandal after scandal after mini scandal coming out over the last month.
James, you know, as these controversies continue to mount, a number of lawmakers have continued to call for a total overhaul of the IRS. First of all, how difficult would that be? And if it were to happen, how would they go about doing that?
It would be very, very difficult. The IRS is pretty insulated. The big issue that it ties into, which has been on the top of both parties' agendas for 2013, is tax reform. And there's kind of two schools of thought on what this IRS scandal does. Some people say this is the reason we need tax reform, and that could overhaul the IRS. If we simplify our tax code, we take away the need for a lot of these bureaucrats. And then on the other side, you want to say, well, just let's fix the house that's broken, let's get the system in order, let's put in control so that this kind of thing can't happen again, and have a very pared down piece of legislation. And it really is still not clear, when I talk to folks on the Hill, what way we're going to go.
Shira, I want to pivot here and talk about immigration for just a second. First of all, I want to apologize to Mr. Ernest. I called him John Ernest. It's obviously Josh Ernest, White House spokesman. Immigration, we knew it was going to be a steep climb. How steep is it going to be when Congress comes back next week?
It's going to be steep. First, you have the vote coming to the Senate in the next week or so, we think, and then it has to go through the House. And you're already seeing some of the bill's greatest champions in the Senate going over and trying to talk to their House colleagues. And you just can't emphasize enough how different these two bodies are at this point. It's going to be very difficult, given how conservative the House is, to be able to push this through. Now, Republicans who control the House do know that they have a problem with Hispanic voters, and that might be enough of an impetus to put many more of the what's left of the moderate Republicans left in Congress on board. But it would involve perhaps House Speaker John Boehner perhaps violating the Hassert rule, voting on something without the support of the majority of his caucus once again. It's a dicey situation for House Republicans.
Shira Toplitz, roll call. James Holman, Politico. Big thanks to both of you. Up next, survival stories.